morning, everyone. My name is Letitia Bracey, and I am Public Affairs Manager for IKEA US. And we are thrilled to have you all here this morning to break ground on the future IKEA Norfolk. IKEA first opened its stores here in the United States in 1985 in suburban Philadelphia, and since then we have grown very slowly and particularly from coast to coast, and now we're kind of moving in. And we only have 46 stores here in the U.S., and a lot of people say only 46 stores, but if you've ever been to an IKEA and seen how massive they are, you would understand that we don't just build stores anywhere. It's a very thoughtful process for us to get to an IKEA building. Like I said, we don't build anywhere or often, but the other thing that I would like to share is that when we do select a location, we are committing not only economically, but to be a good neighbor and a responsible community member wherever we choose. So that's the commitment we're making here to not only the state of Virginia, but the city of Norfolk. Our concept is to provide everything for the home under one roof and to understand how our customers live life at home. And then to provide affordable solutions in our stores through our inspirational room settings, through our design services, and through our building services for those that are looking to renovate their homes. We also have architectural design services that we offer in our stores. So this is why it's important for us to begin this phase of expansion and to really bring our product and our services closer to the communities that we serve and to our customers. And so that's one of the reasons why we're all here today, and we're so excited that we're finally breaking ground on a new store, our second store in Virginia. And with that, I now have the privilege of introducing the president of IKEA Property, Angel Robinson Gaylord. Angel joined IKEA in 2016 as vice president over our real estate division and was quickly promoted to president of US Property in June of 2017. And she oversees all matters related to retail property expansion, acquisition, and management for our country. So with that, I'd like to welcome Angel Robinson Gaylord.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much. We are so excited to be here in Norfolk with you this morning. We are thrilled to be breaking ground here on our future store in Norfolk, Virginia. With only our 46 stores here in the U.S., we are focused on expanding our presence in key regions of the country. So to complement our store in Northern Virginia and the stores in neighboring North Carolina, we are expanding our southern presence by bringing a little bit of Sweden to the Hampton Roads area. IKEA is a destination retailer, attracting regional customers, many of whom are known to drive great distances to visit our stores and experience our brand. With this concept in mind, we seek locations that are highly visible and easily accessible from major highways. And that's exactly what we found here on the 19 acres, that we will build 315,000 square feet of a store that will open and be a member of the Norfolk community. When IKEA chooses to open a store in an area, we are intentionally making a commitment to the community. We buy the land, we build the building, we hire locally, and we promise to be good to the environment and a good business neighbor. We take pride in being a great place to work. Over the years, we have been recognized as the top 100 employer of choice for all of the things that we do for the communities that we serve, as well as the great benefits that we provide to our coworkers. In addition to the 500 construction workers that will be helping to build this store, IKEA will hire approximately 250 coworkers to work and be a part of our IKEA family. And we look forward to building a great team here in Norfolk. And some of our future IKEA Norfolk team members are here with us in the back of the room, and we're very excited to have them with us today. And while there are many who can't wait to shop and work here, there are so many more customers that are already here and waiting to be a part of the IKEA family. we have approximately 35,000 IKEA customers currently in the Norfolk area. And we are excited to be able to bring our products and services closer to them. I would like to now acknowledge some of the members that have been integral to bringing this project to life. First up is our broker, Cezanne Cortinas of Devaris Real Estate. Cezanne had a vision over a decade ago that IKEA would be a perfect fit for the Norfolk community. It is her dedication and hard work that brings us here to this day. Closely partnered with Cezanne is Annette Banks, our real estate project manager. Annette recently left IKEA, which we're very sad about, to pursue another opportunity, but her commitment to this project has led her to be with us here today to participate in this momentous event. Next, I would like to thank the City of Norfolk, Mayor Alexander, and Mayor Frame, the City Council members, and the members of the City of Norfolk staff, especially Jared Chalk and Frida Burns. The City of Norfolk has welcomed IKEA with open arms, and in every challenge or obstacle that we encountered, they moved mountains to get them out of our way. We appreciate the strong partnership that we've had with the City of Norfolk, and we look forward to continuing that into the future. We would also like to thank Governor McAuliffe and Congressman Scott for attending today's event and for the strong partnership the great Commonwealth of Virginia has provided to us to make this day occur. We'd also like to thank the various members of the staff and departments for the Commonwealth of Virginia for removing every obstacle and finding solutions to the challenges that we've had to bring this project to life. There are hundreds of IKEA co-workers that will play a part in this project. And I just want to acknowledge a few key members of our team that will be participating in this project. First up is our construction manager, Joe Maiali, project leader, Kevin Bohan, project operations manager, Mark Robinson, and our store manager, our future store manager, our existing store manager, Charlie Blisco. Additionally, we've had a lot of members of our IKEA family travel from our Woodbridge store in Northern Virginia to help us celebrate and welcome the newest member of our IKEA family who visited us and as well as our field team here with us today. IKEA can't complete this project alone. We have many strong consultants and partners that help us to get to this and to deliver this project. First up, we'd like to acknowledge and thank Dan Wagesbeck and the entire Greenberg Faro family for their support with our project architecture and development coordination services, Randy Royal and the entire Kimley Horn organization for their expertise in managing our civil and traffic engineering needs, Lincoln's Construction Company, who will handle our construction management, Wilcox Savage, our local council, GET Solutions for their geotechnical services, and Code Consultants for Code Consulting and Fire Protection Services. Finally, I'd like to thank all of you for being here today with us to celebrate this milestone, and we look forward to seeing you all in a little over a year to welcome our newest member of our family, the fantastic IKEA Norfolk. Thank you so much, and have a great day.
Now I have the honor of introducing our Congressman, Bobby Scott. Bobby Scott is currently serving his 13th term in Congress, representing Virginia's 3rd Congressional District. Congressman Scott currently serves as the ranking member on the Committee on Education and the Workforce, the committee he has served on since his arrival to Congress in 1993. In his capacity as the most senior Democrat on the committee, he is leading the fight for access to quality early, secondary, and higher education for all of America's children. Additionally, the Congressman is focused on ensuring that millions of Americans have the opportunity to go to work every day and know that they will be treated fairly,
paid a decent and living wage, given a safe environment in which to do their jobs, and provided access to affordable health care. We are so honored that you are here today with us and that you were able to take some time out of your busy schedule. Everyone, please welcome Congressman Bobby Scott. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Gracie, for your very kind introduction. And I want to welcome IKEA to Norfolk. It's a pleasure to be here with Governor McAuliffe and Mayor Alexander, who I'm sure is just as excited about today as I am. IKEA is the kind of company, as you just pointed out, that we want in the labor market. Your commitment to pushing progressive workplace policies like parental leave, a comprehensive minimum wage, tuition assistance, mentorship assistance, and environmentally responsible business practices all provide a clear model for other businesses in our area. With these three priorities at the center of IKEA's mission statement, you have the opportunity to set the standard of what a workforce-centered company really looks like. And I'm pleased to know that Virginia's workers will benefit from this model. I'm particularly excited about the job growth this project will bring to the Norfolk area, 500 construction jobs, 250 permanent jobs, and you will be hiring from a well-educated, well-trained workforce. They are trained and educated at quality public schools, four-year colleges, community colleges, and career schools. Virginia's labor market is strong and growing and will continue to do so long as companies like IKEA continue to come to us. And of course, all of this economic opportunity is only possible because IKEA produces innovative furniture at reasonable prices. So I want to extend my congratulations to all of you here who've worked so hard over the years to get this project off the ground. And I want to especially thank our job-creating governor for not slowing down in the last few weeks of his administration. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Congressman. Now I have the pleasure of introducing someone whose administration played an important role in helping secure the project we are breaking ground on today. Governor McAuliffe is working every day to build the new Virginia economy by creating jobs in the 21st century. A lifelong entrepreneur, Governor McAuliffe brings a common sense business approach to his position as the Commonwealth's chief job creator. And the results obviously speak for themselves. Since the start of his administration, the number of jobs in Virginia has increased by over 200,000. He has closed over 1,000 economic deals that will bring a record-breaking $18.76 billion in capital investment into the Commonwealth in the coming years. That's billions more than any other governor in Virginia's history. Virginia's unemployment rate has declined from 5.4% in January 2014 to 3.7% today, which is the lowest rate in more than 9 years. And that's the second lowest rate of any major state. Through his efforts, Governor McAuliffe made Virginia a national leader on a variety of issues. He also served as chairman of the National Governors Association, and he made cybersecurity his signature program. He's been nationally recognized for his work restoring more civil voting rights than any other governor in U.S. history. He has worked to make Virginia an open and welcoming place to do business, and he has led 35 trade missions to more than two dozen countries. Ladies and gentlemen, the 72nd governor of the Commonwealth of Virginia.
Thank you. Good morning, everybody. Thank you. Sit down. What an honor to be here with IKEA. Leticia, I thank you. And Jill, great to have you here with us today. This is a great announcement. The greatest mayor in America, I want to thank you. The greatest member of Congress that's ever walked the halls of Congress. I mean, are we lucky or not here in Virginia? It is great. This is a big announcement. I remember last year we were all meeting to get the final pieces of this put together. So it's going to be great putting that shovel in the ground today. Such a fabulous company. As they've said, we'll join 46 other locations around the country, 410 around the world in 49 different countries, a very, very successful company. We're so honored. I know you had a lot of places you could go in the United States of America, and I want to thank you for choosing Norfolk. You obviously picked the greatest city in America to do this, and we're very proud of all the work you've done. I'll be here all day, Mr. Mayor. We We're opening a one-stop employment center a little bit later, and in addition, a big housing conference. So I'm going to spend most of the day here in Norfolk, which I love. We also have some big news. What time is it right now? Close enough. 10 o'clock, we'll be announcing, just to change the talking points, unemployment rate in Virginia has dropped to 3.6%. So that's the lowest we've had in nearly 10 years. So we really are really getting a structural full employment here in the Commonwealth of Virginia. But it's really about recruiting great companies to come here. In fact, 2 days ago, I just got back from Germany and Denmark and England. We have a slew of new companies that we will be announcing. My goal is to get to $20 billion by the time I leave office. We're about to go over $19 billion on Monday. All these represent new, great jobs. Our state is doing great, and it's an honor to put a shovel in the ground. I thank you for having our pictures up here on the wall. Very thoughtful there. I know Congressman Scott's is the biggest, though, so I know what your favorites are. But to the city council and everybody else, I mean, this is another just a great announcement. As I wind up my term in the next 2 months, I can't count the number of announcements we've had here in Norfolk. Literally the billions of investment and so many jobs created because it's such a great city and it's such a great workforce. So we welcome IKEA, and I look forward to doing the shovel with you. Thank you very much. Oh, wait. Wait. Where is my flag? Jake forgot the flag. Come on up, Angel, come on up. And Letitia, I have a beautiful flag for you that he meant to bring in. I don't want to forget it. So early this morning, I got up very, very early. And our beautiful Capitol, which was designed by Thomas Jefferson in 1785, it's actually beautiful there. It's got all the new bleachers already set up for the inauguration on January 13th for our new governor, Ralph Northam, who lives in Norfolk. Let's give him a great round of applause. Which would be exciting. So Ralph and I got up very early this morning, and I climbed up on our Capitol. Well, that may not be true. However, this flag did fly over our beautiful Capitol, and when the construction is done in 2019 and when the customers start flowing into your beautiful new store, I'd ask that you fly this beautiful flag in front of your new facility here in Norfolk, Virginia. And thank you for your continued commitment to Virginia.
We look honored.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Beautiful. I folded it up and everything myself.
Thank you so much, Governor. Last but certainly not least, I have the pleasure of introducing the mayor of this great city, whose administration has been a driving force around the success of our acquisition of this land, and at every step of the way, making sure that we are welcomed to the city of Norfolk. Kenneth Cooper Alexander was elected mayor of the city of Norfolk on May 3rd, 2016. A native of Norfolk and president of the Metropolitan Funeral Service, he began his public service career more than two decades ago. Before his election as mayor, Mr. Alexander served in the Senate of Virginia, where he was a member of the Committees on Commerce and Labor, Finance, Transportation, and Privileges and Elections. Before his election to the Senate, he represented the 89th District in the House of Delegates from 2002 until 2012, serving on the Committees of Commerce and Labor, Education, Privileges, and Elections and Rules. Please welcome the mayor of the great city of Norfolk, Kenny Alexander.
Well, good morning. Thank you, Tish. Thank you, NJL, for being here. Thank you, IKEA, for selecting Norfolk, the greatest city and the greatest country in the world, Norfolk, Virginia. Thank you for being here. I do want to acknowledge the presence of members of the City Council. We do this in partnership. Tommy Smigel, Mamie Johnson, Don Hester, who will be the next treasurer of our city, who served on our council as well. I'll be remiss if I did not mention Paul Frame, who actually set this in motion, and Barkley Wynn and others who had served. Let me also mention our city manager, Douglas Smith, and the entire team Norfolk is here to support. We're grateful. We're grateful that you decided to build a store here in the city of Norfolk to create 500 construction jobs, 250 permanent jobs, over 331 or 15,000 square feet of retail space, certainly this is a game changer for the city of Norfolk. Congressman Scott, thank you for what you do for workforce and development. But let me say this, this would not have happened if it had not been for Governor McAuliffe. He got involved very early, physically, emotionally, spiritually. He was involved in this project to ensure that we get this project off the ground. Governor McAuliffe, we are grateful for you, and we look forward to 2020. So again, the investment, the job creation, more importantly, the revenues that will be generated here will allow us, Team Norfolk, to continue to invest in education, neighborhoods, as well as workforce development. So again, I look forward to 2019 when we open this door and enjoy some Swedish meatballs and much more. Again, let's have a great groundbreaking and a great show. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Okay, so again, I'd like to thank everyone for being here this morning. But we're here to break ground, right? So I guess we need to go outside at some point and actually pick the shelves up and, you know, throw dirt. So if you bear with us, we want to take a few photos inside, and then everyone feel free to go join us out right outside the tent.
Okay, so should we get this?
Doug.
Done.